From the book of Hosea. Come, let us return to the Lord, for it is he who has torn, and he will heal us. He has struck down, and will bind us up. After 2 days he will revive us. On the third day he will raise us up, that we may live before him. Let us know, let us press on and know the Lord. His appearing is as sure as the dawn. He will come to us like the showers, like the spring rains that water the earth. The word of the Lord.
Healing. The word of the Lord. Amen. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleaned. One of them, realizing he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Someone said to me, if before I came, just, you know, it's a beautiful day outside. It's gorgeous. Well, you have the heat on, it's on the top. Waiting there on the church so we have people coming for healing and it's cold. Do we thank God for being happy? Of course not, we just take it for granted. But God knows we don't have heat. Now, Father's cold here, put the heat on. We gotta eat that whole wall before we come down. You see, part of the healing is an attitude of gratitude. And medical science will tell you, if you are joyful, the medicine can work better on your physical body because the body now works with the medicine. But if you are negative and woe's me and look at this, the body will work against the medicine. Medical science, you don't need faith for that. Medical science can document that for you. So when we came here today for healing, did we come with an attitude of gratitude for what we can do? And to ask God's help so that we can view the positive things. That's how the healing starts. We're going to go through a beautiful ritual and explain it in just a moment. But it's not magic. This is not I dream of genie and she goes like this and hit me in your career. Or bewitch and she just twinkles her nose and no, it doesn't work that way. It's a ritual for the world to see, for us to see that God is at work. But if we don't accept it, if we walk out and say, I still have my pain, it didn't work. This is the doctor's office when you get a shot of morphine and you're feeling good. This is about the healing of our souls. And a byproduct of that healing is the restoration of our body. Now, I have a lovely family here. All right? And I can tell you right now, I know there's home here. Oh, I'm not going to shut up. We're getting there. Very lovely. This is Mom. Mom and Dad came up a couple weeks ago to visit their family. They came up from Columbia. Now, if you do international travel to get into the United States, you must be tested, I know. COVID-19 testing, where you cannot even get on a plane. So they're here, so obviously it was COVID-19. Well, whatever happened from the time they got here, it didn't take long. Dad ended up in the hospital with COVID. Not only did he end up in the hospital with COVID, but at one point it was so bad, doctors were really trying to fight not to incubate him. And praise God they didn't. He's a strong man, and he's recovering. And I said to them today, I said, you know, let's look at the blessings first. Mom and kids right here. Mom and Dad are here, we're not going to come here. Your stress level is not as high as it could be. Here and they were there. And then you try to figure out how to get there. And you're saying your relatives and every minute seems like a week, and every week seems like a year. You can live your life and he's part of it. So the first blessing is if it happens, he's here. They're watching out for him. Secondly, she's not alone. They got her. If anything, they might be fighting against the habit, but they got her. When he's finished, he doesn't need to go back to Columbia. He's staying home here for a while to make sure he's okay. And as a matter of fact, well, we're going to keep him at least for Christmas. That wasn't her plan when she came, I know that. But that is the plan. You see how God's at work? He was going to get sick. But where is the blessing? He's here with his children. And they're at peace. There's a blessing. This sacrament we celebrate is a sacrament of blessing. But I can tell you now, if you came in here with aches and pains, chances are you're going to leave here with aches and pains. But if you came here and looking for an adjustment, a healing, hopefully you might have come in here a little stressed and worried, but you'll leave here less less worried. And you might not even notice that you have a couple of things of pain. Then you're going to realize that, wow, there is a difference. I do feel better because I have this attitude of gratitude. In the ritual, there is a part where the priest comes to lay hands. Due to COVID restrictions and things of that nature, we will not be coming around to individually lay hands on people, but at that point in the celebration of this sacrament, the three of us together can call upon the Holy Spirit from up here. Trust in God. It works. Secondly, we go through it.
God, the only begotten Son, you humbled yourself to share their humanity, and you
responds in mutually consensual fashion with, Lord, you love us.
Lord, you love us.
For our parish family gathered here today, bless them and fill them with new hope, strength, and health. Let us pray.
Lord, you love us.
For the sick, especially those who cannot be here, give them your special love to comfort them in your suffering.
Lord, you love
us. For all who assist the sick tonight, bless them with compassion, kindness, and love. Let us pray.
Lord, you love us.
For our Pope, bishops, and priests, give them the grace to carry out their duties to the people of God. Let us pray.
Lord, you love us.
For the people who have been away from God, give them inspiration to mend their ways and come back to our Heavenly Father. Let us pray.
Lord, you love us.
Father, hear our prayers. Give us what you inspire us and ask for the faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for our preparation for the altar.
What key?
for your mercy, for our brothers and sisters who are killed, that having been with them in their death and their danger, we may rejoice in their recovery and health through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Son of God, the Christ our Lord. In Him you have been pleased to do all things, giving us all a share in His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels and thrones and dominion, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, because without them we are clay.
Thank you. Lord, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and all the pastors of your people. Together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, all the bishops, and all who lead and guide your church, that in the world torn by strife, we may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and peace.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have a call to sleep the peace of your Christ among the dead whose faith you alone have known. Help me the dead to rejoice in the light of your face, in the resurrection hidden in the fullness of life. Grant also to us our earthly pilgrimages done, we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with the Jew forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Saint Joseph, the Apostles and Martyrs, Saint Francis of Assisi, and with all the saints who show praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Thank you. May God fill your hearts with peace and lead you to eternal life.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Mass is ended. Go in peace and love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.